We looked at our inclination of giving way to our judgmental impulse.
Let me get it for you. What's that?
What's that? Phone.
What is it? What is it?
It's a message, a love message.
From you?
From your concubines.
Which concubines? You?
Don't even talk to me, you lying, rotten, bad man!
Hey, but then...
I will break the phone!
Jumping to hasty conclusions.
I will break it! Break the phone.
And by so doing, visiting avoidable pains on those we love.
If only you will listen to me.
I don't have to listen to you. I don't want to listen to you. Why should I dignify you with my attention? Why? Okay. You have a story to tell. You have reasons perhaps for it. But I'll be damned if any reason from you is good enough.
Look, my dear, there was no adultery in the practical sense of it.
Really? All right. So in theory.
You know what? It may be worth our while
if we listen to him first.
I don't have to listen. I will not. Because whether in practice or in theory, adultery is a no-no. And it will not reduce the enormity of what he's done, and it won't change my mind from a decision.
Decision? What decision?
She wants to leave me and sue for divorce.
Oh, no. Divorce? Not after 25 years of happy married life with grown-up children?
Well, your uncle should have considered that before going into his irreprehensible act of adultery.
So, divorce? So final?
Not less final than adultery after 25 whole years.
Please, my dear.
Don't even talk to me! Don't even try to talk to me!
You know what? Let me try to humor him by pretending to listen to him.
Humor him? Whatever he is going to say is bound to offend my sensibilities. You know the worst part of it? Your uncle has not taught me in the last 1 year.
What?
Initially, I was bothered. But I thought maybe he has grown past it. But to think that my darling husband has been saving his energy for his concubines?
It wasn't really like that. How was it like? Please.
Lady and gentlemen, let's not get caught up in platitude.
I'm done. She caught him cheating on her.
Jesus.
Leave Jesus out of this. Look, Mr. Man, I don't like you meddling in an adultery case.
Oh, come on. But he's my uncle. And there must be a reason for this unusual behavior.
So you agree it's unusual, huh? But I don't know what uncle was thinking when he was doing all that. How could a man cheat on his wife after celebrating silver jubilee of their anniversary?
Well, I can't answer your question until I've discussed with them.
I just told you I don't want you to meddle in this adultery case.
But I'm already here. And surprisingly, they are listening to you.
I don't care. I really don't. And maybe that uncle's behavior, that at his age, how could he do that? What was he thinking? What exactly was going through his mind when he was doing it?
Thank you. loneliness, a major threat to happiness and cohesiveness of the family. An isolated person can be lonely at times. But it is not often that a lonely person is isolated. Think of a woman, a man, living with other members of family. They eat together, sleep together, talk with each other, play together. But you know, a lonely person will always be alone.
Hello, gentlemen. I hear you're looking for me.
Come.
What is it? A lembed, I want.
Oh, someone I'm baby.
I'm going to call Embedded. Say, if we will be.
Hey, someone.
They are speaking Egba dialect, I think.
I know that. My name is Willoughby. Chief Willoughby.
What is Chief Willoughby la won?
I'm Willoughby. What are they looking for?
One killer.
Hey, yawo mi le mo baby.
Yawo yi.
Yeah, we're the mom baby.
Talene mbere gan talen wa.
Ko se anu mi.
Ko se. Iyawo mi pupa kan bayi re mom baby. Omobirin na pupa bayi.
Ki o te poruko e.
Mo bi re le bi ni seyin.
Bimbo lo pe, Bimbo.
You're looking for my daughter Bimbo.
Bimbo re mom baby ya ni. Aye yin ada. Ibi mo ya mo la be ku tare mo padi re. I don't care about the padre. Libi le tura aburo mi yo se shi.
The mechanic is done with the car. Who was that old man?
My new catch.
Your new what?
Catch.
The man that is old enough to be your grandfather?
Spare me that.
Shall we go?
I'm not going yet.
Don't tell me you're going back to that old man.
I'm tired of loneliness and I can't go back to loneliness again.
But that doesn't mean you have to go back to that old man.
I can do anything to overcome my loneliness, so I'm not going home.
No, I will stay with you. I will take you home.
Where's the car key?
Ha.
Yes, take a taxi.
What?
Take a taxi.
Don't tell me you're going back to that old man.
Mind your business.
You better look at me, Padre, because if I dress you, me.
You better speak in the language they would understand.
Any bimbo, mommy, lembere? Where is the bimbo herself?
Oluwami, bimbo, get it away.
You knew she has gone out, yet you brought in these people to see her.
Can we?
I think they better be going.
But, Cobb, your father is older than me.
I know.
So, how can he be 9 years old just like you?
Because he only became a father when I was born. Before then, he was just a man, and the question my teacher asked me was, how old was my father?
Interesting logic. Now, your teacher was right to have marked you wrong on this one. This is not the right spelling of crocodile. See? How can you spell crocodile this way?
But the question to me was, how do I spell crocodile, not how crocodile was spelled?
Oh, so, you, how?
I spelled it the way I normally pronounce it.
Which is?
K-R-O-K-O-D-I-A-L.
Write it, I don't get it. K-R-O-K-O-D-I-A-L. Crocodile. Jeez. But, look, you cannot reinvent the principles of universal teachings. It's not done.
No, but...
Mothering child. Isn't it a little late for a home lesson now?
You won't understand. Bimbo, this is more of a new age lecture. The cub here has opened my eyes to new perspective of logic.
My God, Bert, it should be in bed by now.
Absolutely.
I'm waiting for my lion to kiss me goodnight.
But he can always do that whenever he comes.
Yes, yes.
So, on your feet, Mr. Lecturer. Let's go. Come on.
Up you go.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. Let's go. Not so fast. Right here. Love you, darling. My love.
All right. Good night.
Pack your books. I've had enough for today. Rachel, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Let's go!
This way. Night night.
Alright.
smack cam.
No, no, come on, just come over here. Come over here, fight real quick.
Quick, you idiot.
Look into the camera.
Thank you for tuning in to our program, Conversation with Uche. It is a program for ladies to vent and ventilate better. On this program today, we'll be hosting a retired matron who has contributed immensely to the growth of the nation's health sector. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Rekia Odowoli. Thank you for joining us, ma'am.
Thank you so much. I'm highly honored to be here.
Thank you for coming. Okay, our focus on this program today is the increasing population of ladies in their 40s, 50s, 60s, and even 70s having to cope with living alone and being lonely in the event of them being separated from their husband or even the death of their spouse. Can they get a life of excitement without having a man at the background?
I think any woman should count herself lucky and blessed by God for living up to 40 and above, maybe 60, 70, or what have you. And if it so happens that either by death or separation or divorce, she loses her spouse, she should not bother herself about, you know, getting excitement out of life. All she needs to do is, you know, how she's going to live a fruitful and rewarding life as long as God has blessed her with children.
A fruitful and rewarding life with or without a man.
You see, the point here is, yes, I know quite well that some women can actually not stay without having a man as the crown, so the society says, and our society believe, we all know that. But at the same time, we still have strong-spirited women who can stay on their own if a thing like this happens, and they pick up the piece and pieces and go ahead with life, as long as they have their children and their lives to live.
For many in the same situation, in such situation, they get to remarry at whatever age, 70 and even 80s, that has become a fashion. Even for an 80-year-old to get a new bride, and even their children would just justify it that, okay, our daddy needs somebody to take care of him. So why can't women do the same? Why can't women do the same?
See, the point I'm making here is that nobody and no law is stopping a woman from, you know, getting married again or having, you know, a male companion. I think that is what you were referring to about, you know, excitement, having a male lover, if I'm correct.
Yes, you're right.
You know, marriage on its own is a big problem. And if it happens that it did not work, there's no point in rushing into another relationship. All you need to do is just, you know, pick up the piece and pieces of life and move on. Instead of, you know, trying to chase after one man or the other. Because you have your children there. Whether they are 40s or even more than that, your child will always remain a child to you.
Let's take a flip side of the question. Take a look at the same man in their 60s, in their 70s and 80s. Even if they don't remarry, they still get to some form of relationship, either on a permanent or one-off basis. Why can't women do the same? And they also get to go to clubs, pick up girls at any time of the day. Why can't women do the same?
You see, the point here is our society does not allow that. As Africans, we have our own values. You cannot, because a man is running after women and you want to do the same. There are things a man can do and get away with. Does it mean a woman should do the same thing? No. If a woman does that, she cannot get away with it. The society will frown at it. You have to live a responsible life. That is what we are talking about here. And just let the man do whatever. Let him be the runaway man or whatever you.
But then you also talked about lonely ladies giving up a life of excitement with another man just to focus on their children. But then the same man do the same without giving up intimacy with other women. Why can't you do the same as a woman?
Well, the point is nobody is stopping any woman from, you know, getting or having a remarriage or having a male lover. But when we are talking about remarrying, not every woman is lucky enough to have a trustworthy or somebody who can easily replace the husband she had before. If you are even going to venture into trying to get into another relationship, you should really settle down and think straight. The man, are you compatible? Is he a brother, a lover, a father, you know, everything to you? If he is, then you can give it another try. Otherwise, I mean, there's no point.
So you're saying?
What I'm saying is, you know, the basic thing is that you try as much as possible to keep the home from tight. You keep your marriage working because it's an ordained duty by, you know, by God for women to do.
So as a lady, I know that my husband is knowingly cheating on me. He's not gained my trust in whatever form. So I should just stick with him and swallow the bitter pill?
Look, my dear, I'm not, you know, endorsing domestic violence or, you know, of not gaining a trust from your spouse. But the point I'm making here is that, you know, you must live a rewarding, responsible and respectable life. Keep the home fronts going and just leave the man to leave his usual runaway and absentee husband beat. You can't want to play the role of a man when you're a woman. So why did God create you a woman?
Okay, I'll round off on another note, which is an extension of what we're discussing, and that's the role of a woman who has sacrificed so much for her family, especially her children. And when they grow up and they get married, especially the male children, they kind of tend to place more emphasis on their wives and put their mother at the background. How do you balance this kind of relationship?
You see, as women and mothers, it's a responsibility ordained one placed by God on us. It is our duty to see that the marriage works. It's our duty to make sure our children are responsible children and they live a responsible and successful life. You say, but that is not to say that as mothers, we should see it as a profit and loss venture. Because you brought your child or your son alone by yourself, you lived a lonely life, does not mean that you should see yourself competing with your daughter-in-law. Just because your son is the man and you spent all your life training him? No! It shouldn't be so. Because you are lonely does not mean you should take another woman's place and make her unhappy or lonely too.
Yes. Loneliness is a major threat to family health.